First of all, let's review the numbers. Last week we had 72 positive cases. This week we're up 14 to 86. As far as active cases, last week we had 5 active cases, and this week we're up 7 to 12. We had 63 recovered cases last year, and that's been increased to 71, 8 more cases recovered. Last week we had 1 patient in a hospital. This week we have none, so that increased our positive by 1 more. We had 3 deaths, that still remains the same. We had 2,740 tests this week versus 2,103 from last week. And the percentage of the tests that were positive last week were 3.4, and this week only 3.1. So that's moving in the right direction. Last week, Sheboygan County public health officials released a Sheboygan County safe restart recommendation plan to reopen that included strong controls for businesses and residents. We are currently in phase 1 of the plan that says if business is open, they need to follow the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation's best practices and any sanctions specific to their sector. In this plan, community member actions are avoiding going to places where safety measures are not in place, wash your hands with soap and water, or use hand sanitizer, especially after touching frequently used items or surfaces, avoid touching your face, sneeze or cough into the tissue or the inside of your elbow, disinfect frequently used items and surfaces as much as possible, always use cloth face coverings while in public, particularly when using mass transit. If you are sick, stay at home. Do not go to work, school, or any other public place, and follow the advice of your medical practitioner. Follow public health quarantine isolation orders when ill or when you are in close contact with somebody that had COVID-19. Business actions that should be followed in phase 1 are businesses that choose to open must do so using the guidelines from the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation and any sector-specific sanctions that apply to work that's being done. If your sector is not included, the CDC has additional resources for sectors and organizations to reference. Limit the capacity with non-essential businesses, bars, and restaurants and organizations to 25% of your capacity. Events held outdoors should allow for more people to maintain a 6 feet physical distance from others. Support online education or remote work option as you're able. Encourage curbside pickup to reduce in-store traffic and long lines. If community members choose to gather socially, private indoor social gatherings should be limited to 10 people or less with physical distancing. And always wear a cloth mask for staff. Sheboygan has met 2 of the 5 criteria necessary to go on to phase 2. The criteria that have been met is Sheboygan County hospitals have the ability to treat all patients requiring hospitalization, and every resident who tested positive for COVID-19 is interviewed within 24 hours of the test results. The criteria that still need to be met is a downward trajectory of positive cases of COVID-19 as a percentage of the total tests, adequate PPE available for healthcare personnel, and testing availability for all residents with COVID-like symptoms. The Public Health Department has scheduled a community testing opportunity at the Sheboygan County Fairgrounds in conjunction with the National Guard on May 28th and 29th, next Thursday and Friday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m., and on Saturday, May 30th from 8 o'clock until 4 p.m. Any resident older than 5 with a COVID-19 symptom can be tested. Emergency management is working to bring additional PPE in for healthcare partners to have an 8 days or more supply of PPE on hand. If these criteria are met in the next 2 weeks, then Sheboygan can move on to phase 2 of the safe restart recommendations. City Hall is now open to the public. The Mead Public Library is open to the public with limited hours on Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. and on Saturday from 10 a.m. to 2 o'clock p.m. The third floor and meeting rooms are still closed. Municipal Court will be meeting but conducting virtual hearings for the next few months. All city parks have remained open, but the following park facilities are closed and will be closed until June 30th and reevaluated based on the Sheboygan County Safe Restart Guidelines. All city park playgrounds remain closed. All park buildings and shelters are closed. And city park restrooms will have a phased reopening as new dispensers for hand washings are installed. The Senior Activity Center will remain closed. And starting June 1st, Shoreline Metro will resume half-hour service weekdays from 5:45 a.m. to 5:45 p.m. and maintain capacity of 10 riders on each bus. Currently, there is a one-hour service midday, and complimentary free fares are still available for riders. Thank you very much, and have a great day today. Thank you.